Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and this is the first time I'm making a solo scours video in I don't even know how long, but a very long time. I need to put that overlay on because I don't want to hear that nether portal sound. So I just wanted to talk about ranked skywars because I feel like, well, it's kind of just something I want to talk about, and I thought I killed this guy. Are you kidding me? I got particles but no hit. Bruh, he just stole my kill. That's not fair. Okay, I'm dead. I'm gonna die. And I'm dead. I love fighting other diamond divisions in solo. It's the most fun thing ever. But yeah, I just wanted to talk about ranked and give some feedback on it. And like just kind of giving my opinions on some things they should add and some things they should just change up. So my first concern, they need to add some sort of grace period at the beginning of the game. I know a lot of people would be opposed to this. A lot of people that aggro people. But like, wouldn't you say that would be a good idea? So that everyone can go to mid, you know, get geared and stuff, then go back to the island, and then the grace period's over. So no one gets attacked right off the bat. I don't know, but I just think that's the best option because everyone's still going to be rushing mid to try and get the enchantment table and anvil and maybe a couple mid chests. Even though, you know, as I said, it's not the most reliable strat and not the safest thing to do. But you know, people are still going to do it because they're just so used to it and they've built their playstyle around it. I'm going to get this chest really quick if I can. Okay. Just blocks, but I kind of didn't need that. Oh, he jumped off. But that's just what I think. I think they need to add a grace period at the beginning of the game, and that'll make it just a little bit better, you know? So that at the start of a game, I don't feel like, and I'm rushing mid, I don't feel like I'm risking everything. I can just rush mid with peacefully without being attacked, and then you can go back to mid. But I feel like that grace period should not be implemented at all rating. This is the problem with grace periods. Like, it shouldn't be implemented at zero rating because you don't really need a grace period at zero rating. But I feel like it should be at like 1.5k or something it should start, or like 2k when like people actually start playing seriously kind of and rushing mid like that. That's when I feel like it should be. But the problem with that is a lot of people or a lot of your games are not going to be, if you're at like 2k, a lot of your games are not going to be filled with other people with 2k because Hypixel's matchmaking for ranked is just not very good. So along with that, for that grace period to actually work, they need a better matchmaking system so that if I'm at 2.2k, let's say, or like 2.1k, and I queue people, I should be getting people that are around like 2k, 2.1k, right? Maybe even 2.2 or 2.3. But then I queue people that are below 1,000. What is that? That's unfair for the people below 1,000, and that's also just, it doesn't make sense. I should be queuing people around my skill level, not people that are just new to the game or haven't played much that season. And like, not that those people that I queue that are like below 1,000, you know, they're actually good at the game. No, some of them are literal bots and they don't know how to play. So I don't know why I queue some of those people. It's kind of bad. They need to fix up the matchmaking system, and then they can implement something like the grace period at the beginning of the game, and then just implement that at like 2k rating, because that's when people actually start like trying for the most part. All right, let's kill this guy and end the game really quick. I'm the best in the game and I'm actually gonna die. No, I'm not. I cannot die. I just froze for a second. What the heck? Okay. He's dead. GG. But yeah, that's just my take on that rushing mid strat. Just need to add a grace period at the beginning of a game at like 2k plus rating, along with a better matchmaking system so that'll actually work well. And it'll be more fair for the people, you know, just starting or just, you know, getting into ranked skywars. It'll be good for a lot of those people as well. I know some people might complain about that because when you get a low rating game, you're gonna be happy. You're gonna automatically have like confidence or... No, obviously you can't check in game if you got a low rating game, but like if you just check after the game that you queued a low rating game, then you would be happy because then you know those people have low rating and you would want to queue them. And so when you don't queue them, you know, you get out of that game or something. I know a lot of people would like to just, you know, keep this matchmaking system that we have because we queue low rated players sometimes, but that also translates to us queuing a lot of higher rated players a lot. This guy's bee hopping. What? Are you kidding me? Okay. I would also like to thank the ranked staff for their work that they've done, because back in April, I'm pretty sure number 10 by the end of the season was like 5k. Now number 10 is like 3.1, which is a normal amount, and I'm glad the staff team has actually taken responsibilities into their own hands, because it was needed. It was really needed. Now ranked is actually playable, and masters is actually achievable. I'm gonna try my best to beat this guy. I don't have as much armor, so I don't even know. I don't have many blocks, so I can't build a lava tower onto him. I don't want to engage in combat just yet. Did he eat a gap? Okay, he didn't. All right. Let me see. Oh gosh, he does too much damage. That's a rip. But yeah, like, they've done an incredible job. Obviously, there are still cheaters. There's still many, many closet cheaters in ranked. But at least there are barely any fly hackers. The last fly hacker I fought was when I was, like, just getting to 2.2k. His name was II Cheater. But like, I kind of liked that guy, because he didn't do it off of spawn. Oh, it's this guy again. Oh, I got this this time. This kid, he's stupid. He's just rushing in. Got him. Okay, yeah, I take my revenge. Cheater, goodbye. But yeah. Oh, shoot, this guy. Let me get this guy first. Okay, got him. Yeah, there are still many closet cheaters in ranked, and they still need to have some sort of different anti-cheat to catch closet cheaters, because they don't get caught. Closet cheaters do not get caught, and that's a real problem. They really do need to get caught, because closet cheaters are really annoying. Even though I'd prefer to fight a closet cheater, I don't know. Would I prefer to fight a closet cheater or a fly hacker? That may seem like an obvious answer, but for me, fighting fly hackers is fun, because the stupid ways I try to kill them in, it's just funny. I don't know. I have more fun trying to kill them than closet cheaters. Obviously, I'd prefer to fight a closet cheater in terms of trying to win the game, because, well, obviously I could actually at least beat them. But I'd prefer to fight a beehopper / fly hacker to have more fun, because it's funnier. It's not as funny to be a closet cheater, or as, like, I don't know, rewarding. I mean, it's not really rewarding to kill a beehopper either. I guess you get excited, but like, you wouldn't really get as excited to kill a closet cheater. So yeah, fighting beehoppers is also just more interesting, but still, I'd rather fight a closet cheater, and I hope beehoppers never come back to ranked. There's still beehoppers, obviously, in solo, like you just saw, but I don't really care too much about solo. I know other people will, but like, starting next season, I'm gonna be becoming a ranked main, because I feel like that's the best option for me. Way less cheaters in ranked in terms of like beehoppers. There are hardly any anymore. Okay, this guy wants his revenge from last game. Bro, I'm just trying to commentate, bro. It's hard to commentate in playing. I haven't done this in so long. It's just hard to. But yeah, I'm gonna be becoming a ranked main over a solo main. I've been a solo main ever since I started playing, and it's been pretty fun, you know, but at times it's just gotten super annoying. And I've noticed myself just saying to myself, ranked is so much better than this, because ranked is a little bit more balanced, you know. It's still pretty unbalanced, but it's more balanced than this, in my opinion. And it's just more competitive and more fun. It's not always the most fun thing to be dominating all the time. I mean, yeah, it can be, but like, it's not always the most fun thing. I like having competition. Competition is fun. If you were talking to me like 2 years ago, I would definitely disagree, and I would say I would never main ranked or play ranked more often than I did, because that was when I used to struggle for gold division. Now I can get diamond division on like the first or second day if I really tried. So yeah, also I was going for masters, right? And on the 19th, that was the last day I properly played. On the 19th, an hour after my ranked session, my internet just died. It was so bad that like, I couldn't play ranked without ping spiking or getting kicked from the server or anything like that. So I had to just not play. I couldn't play. I wanted to play super bad, but I just couldn't. I had no option to. My internet just would not allow me. So from the 20th through the 25th, I just didn't play ranked. That cost me getting masters, because now I'm way too far behind to really catch up in like the next today, tomorrow, the next day, and the next day. Because I definitely am not playing on the last day. That's just bad. That's just a bad idea. So yeah, that costed me getting masters. I'm going to try again next season. Hopefully my internet doesn't die. And so if you're wondering, I got to 2300. That's pretty good. But it's my highest rating, but like, it's not what I expected. I expected more. You know, I would have gotten more if my internet didn't die. And so yeah, I kind of lost all my momentum. And so if I, you know, started trying to play again to get masters, monsters at towards the end of the season, I would just like lose it all, I feel, because I had so much momentum, but now it's just all gone. This guy is, oh my gosh, how is he not beating me? Like, he has so much more gear. How does he have full diamond like every game? He has so much more gear. He has pearls and gaps, and he's still struggling. I mean, I'm sky basing, yeah, but that's really to commentate. I know it's not interesting, so I should probably just go fight him. I'd probably die, but I still believe I can win, even if it's a long game. He's trying so hard. Yeah, he's just gonna go in for me now. Okay, I actually missed that. I suck. He's probably so happy right now. But yeah, I got to 2300. Not gonna play for the rest of the season probably, because, you know, my momentum's ruined, and I think 2300 is a decent place to stop. It's my highest rating, so that's cool, but still, no, not masters. So yeah, that excuse that I always made, that I didn't play for like most of the season, that's why I never get high rating. Well, that's true. I didn't get to play for this whole season either, and I didn't get too high rated. I mean, 2300 is still pretty high, I guess, right? But it's not as high as I was hoping for, and as I needed that to be. I needed that to be way higher. Would have been. I was well on my way. I was doing well, and then that just happened. There we go. So yeah, I was at like 2287 for like that entire period where my internet was just dead. And then yesterday I was like, okay, I want to play ranked, so let me just, you know, gain some rating. And I got to, oh gosh, I got to 2317, and it wasn't too bad. Like, ranked, like I remember, was not too hard to win. It just isn't, and that's fact. So yeah, I'm really excited to become a ranked main. I hope you guys agree with that decision. Like, I should become a ranked main. I know most of my videos recently have been ranked, and I guess it was kind of hinting towards that I was gonna be playing ranked a lot more and recording ranked a lot more. So yeah, starting next season, I've said this for like the past two seasons, but like, I think starting next season, either I'll daily stream or daily record, either one of those. I think sometimes last season I just didn't feel like it, or this season I mean, I just didn't feel like it, but I think next season I should be able to, hopefully. For the most part, I will be able to. Maybe towards the end of the month when like school starts back up, I might not be able to. There we go. Almost died because I froze again. I don't know why I'm freezing so much. I probably need to just restart my PC. My PC has been like slow today and yesterday because I haven't like restarted it at all, but it usually hasn't been doing this. I have fire, so that's good. This guy's fire resistance. It's fine, because I can just combo him and kill him and get this guy as well. Oh, wait, no. Boots. There we go. Now I can fight you. Oh, he doesn't even have sharpness. Oh, he missed a pearl. Let's go. Alright, that was the end of today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you next time. Peace.